so hope you enjoy.
All right, so the beginning of this video is going to be a voiceover. This is the half-inch steel I started with. You can see it's pretty rusted and dirty and pretty rough looking, but it's going to look cool. This is after I polished it so I could get the drawing on there. There's my free-handed drawing of the blade. And there's the rough cut after I angle ground it. Here is me beginning to sharpen the blade. It's you can see all the different edges and everything. Here I'm just trying to get a shot of all the different features. You know, you got to move the camera around to get different lighting and just show all the different faces.
So I tried brassing it. It's not ready yet, but I just wanted to see what it would look like to see if I want to do the final product brassed. It was like a half fail because the heat distortion made it discolored, but I think it looks kind of cool like that. It looks like battle-worn golden blade. It's very cool.
Here I took half inch bar and I heated it up with the oxyacetylene to bend it over my vise, and then I welded it to the handle. That's the bottom of the handle, and I thought it looked pretty cool.
This one was a lot of work. So there's the blade. You've already seen that in this steamy water bucket. Ooh, it's hot. It's hot, it's hot, it's hot. Oh! Yeah. Whoo, it's hot. Like a raptor claw or something. That's the handle. So it's gonna be like that. And then the blade's gonna come out the top. Whoo, that's hot. Pretty sweet. Into the bathroom. And I look up. Oh no! I'm a dirty boy.
Here is my first image of the guard after I just did the rough cut in sand. Here I use Sharpie to show the nail beginnings.
This one right here is mostly done putting nails on the claw. This is the closest thing I'll ever get to filing nails. Yeah, you know, I got the other two started, but they're still really rough. That one's looking pretty damn good though.
I got my chucks and my dickies and I put it on black. Banging Sinatra in a flat Cadillac. My old lady leaning out the whole window. Everybody. Even though they all say that they're real, I know that most aren't. Boy, you think you're clever, don't you? Girl, you think you're so smart. Come with me to another side of the world so cold and so dark.
A world so cold, a world where only some will go. But none return. When will they learn? When do
three, five, four, four. I think I smell the scent of a placenta. I enter Central Park, it's dark, it's winter in December. I see my target, put my car in park and approach a tender. Young girl by the name of Brenda, and I pretend to befriend her. Sit down beside her like a spider. Hi there, girl, you might have heard of me before. See, whore, you're the kind of girl that I'd assault and rape and figure why not try to make your pussy wider. Fuck you with an umbrella, then open it up, but the shit's inside ya. I'm the kind of guy that's mild, but I might flip and get a little bit wilder. Impregnate a lesbian, yeah, now let's see her have triplets and milder. Disintegrate them babies as soon as they're out her with formalder. Hide in cyanide, girl, you can try and hide, you can try to scream louder. No need for no gunpowder, that only takes all the fun outer. Murdering, I'd rather go bin bin, and now you see just powder. Fuck, I do just what I do when I cut right through your scalp. Shit, wait a minute, I mean stall, my knife seems dull, pull another one out. Soon as my flow starts, I compose art like the ghost of Mozart. Even though they all say that they're real, I know that most aren't. Boy, you think you're clever, don't you? Girl, you think you're so smart. Come with me to another side in a world so cold and so dark.
A world so cold, a world where only some will go. But none return, when will they learn? Where do they go? God only knows, stay wide awake.
So dark and so cold, my friends don't know this other side of me. There's a monster inside of me, it's quite ugly and it frightens me. But they can't see what I can see, there's a vacancy in my tummy. It's making me play hide and seek like Jason, I'm so hungry. She's naked, see no privacy, but I can see she wants me. So patient, see I try to be, but she, why does she taunt me? Pulls the drapes and she goes right to sleep, and I creep right through the front seat. So blatantly, but silently, cause I know that she's sound asleep. Who's waking me so violently, and why is he on top of me? He's raping me, she tries to scream, somebody please get him off me. He's taping me, he's biting me, he's laughing like it's funny. She's scraping me, she's fighting me, she's scratching like some dumb freak. Escaping me, no dice to see, I might just be Ted Bundy. Or Satan G, what a sight to see, I'm dancing in my red panties. I'm crazy, but it's alright with me, man, life can be so empty. Stay away from me, cause I'm dancing to quite a different drum beat.
Soon as my flow starts, I compose art like the ghost of Mozart. Even though they all say that they're real, I know that most aren't. Boy, you think you're clever, don't you? Girl, you think you're so smart. Come with me to another side in a world so cold and so dark. A world so cold, a world where only some will go. But none return, when will they learn? Where do they go? God only knows, stay wide awake.
Better try to stay wide awake, cause you might end up found dead by the lake. Soon as you lay me down to sleep, it's your soul I'ma try to take. Pray for light today, right away. Why do they try to fight today? I must make them pay twice as much. Might as well put the knife away. Now I use power tools. How about now? Are you in the shower? Scour you for 6 hours to outage your power outlets. How did you figure out I was down in your basement? Now ya must have just heard the sound of my stomach growling from down there. Prowler, there's no one fouler. Bound ya, that's how they found ya. Face down in the tub, I drown ya with piles of downers around ya. Such nostalgia and power, such prowess. Look how you cower. Jump out on you now like I was a Jawa from fucking Star Wars. Jabba the Hutt, bitty baba, bitty baba, it's time to da-da. Or to not even bother to scream, it don't even matter. Amazing when grazing skin with these razor blades he waves at ya. Not your everyday Damien, bathe me in holy water. Nothing like Son of Sam, so please understand there's no gun in hand. Where's the thrill in the hunt? There's no fun in that. Here I come with axe. Fun to act like Lumberjack when I'm hacking them up with that. What was that? Dial 911, someone's coming in from the
soon
back.
Soon as my flow starts, I compose art like the ghost of Mozart. Even though they all say that they're real, I know that most aren't. Boy, you think you're clever, don't you? Girl, you think you're so smart. Come with me to another side in a world so cold and so dark. A world so cold, a world where only some will go. But none return, when will they learn? Where do they go? God only knows, stay wide awake.
Yep, so, that was a cool montage, huh? I hope you think it was. So, I still need to do some more sanding on the blade, but I'm itching to get it all together to, so I can do some other things. Here's how I made the fingers look kind of creepy. I added the knuckle wrinkles, and, I'm going to brass the nails, then clean up the brass around here, and then, Sharpie over the brass, gun blue it after it's all attached. And I'm going to do the same thing with the guard. I'm going to brass the nail and then Sharpie over it and gun blue it. And you can see the blade looks kind of rough, but and it's got some little divots here from the die grinding in here. But I can sand that off. But I really want to see it together, so I'm going to weld it together. Okay, so this is going to be tricky. Ugh. Plus I'm barefoot and I always burn my toes when I do this. With no shoes on, but I don't feel like getting them on. So, I have to stand for, well, no. Just to get it tacked, I have to be sitting. I'll tack it on these points, and then I can do this. So I just gotta make sure this is on straight. I need gloves! Okay, that's better. When I'm having my hand so close to the weld. I always hit it when I have the welding helmet on. That's a cool sound. One big thing that took me a lot longer to figure out than it should have is that this is a flux core welder, so in the middle of the in the strand there's flux, and if you don't clean off the flux that burns on the metal, then you get holes like when I did this. But this doesn't matter. I'm going to leave it like that because this gets wrapped in leather. And I'm going to wrap it in between the fingers around here and stuff, so. Alright, finish welding this puppy. Oh. Alright, let's see how clean that was after I cool it off. I need that. That looks so cool. Pretty good view of Thor's hammer there, huh? That's like on the super back burner right now. I've lost all motivation to do it.
Thank you.
So I obviously did not penetrate very well because the whole thing is... Yeah, it's shaking on there. So I'm going to take the die grinder. I'm going to die grind a big divot out of there and then fill it. Ow. Wait. Yeah, I'm like way zoomed in right now. Can you see it? Ow. Alright, so I took the die grinder. It's probably what I should have done to begin with. You can see there's like a big trench in there. So we're going to try again. I'm also, you know, Mike Goll, he also has commented on one of my videos, the Demon Blade video, and he was like, you know, I could just picture him just like yelling at me. He's like, you need to weld the guard on the backside, and I was like, so I'm going to weld on the top too, just for extra strength, because this point right here is so thin, and I know he's going to break it, but I got to try my best for him to not break it. Wish me luck. Shit. That's a weak tech. Keep doing that. Alright, it ain't pretty, but it's at least solid, not moving anymore. So I'm going to attach the handle, then I'll flip it over and weld the top area right there. Okay, so where is the handle? Right here. And as you can see, I ground a bevel on it, so that should make it fun to center. I need... That was crazy. I know what Michael's talking about now. When you're holding something, you can feel it pull. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that pulled big time. I wonder if I weld the other side, if it'll pull it the other way. But if I do that, then it's stuck. Fuck it. You only live once. Wow, this thing's heavy. God damn. We'll do the full weld and turn it back on. Before I say anything, I never claimed to be a welder. If anybody's wondering, I'm an electronics technician. Oh. Yeah, I wire wheeled it, and it's pretty lumpy and bumpy, but I think I got good penetration. This whole guard was glowing when I was welding it, so, and then there's the top portion. I think I might leave, like, grind this into a slope up and then up, just to leave as much weld as I can for extra strength, you know, when you're cleaving it. But, yeah. As strong as I it is absurd looking. And it's big, it's heavy. Probably not anything, it's probably not nothing to, Michael, though. He builds the giant stuff. I kind of want to do the gun blue tonight, but it's already 7:30 p.m. and I live in a trailer park. Yes, I do all this in a trailer. I got to grind this weld out before I can do the gun blue, so tomorrow. So, it's tomorrow now, and, time to grind out this weld. I'm using this fancy, interleaf flap disc where the sanding pad goes around the edge for cleaning up corners. That's what it's made for. So, let's see how it does. It's like a 40 grit, so it should take it down fairly quickly. Probably one of the cleanest welds that I've gotten with this crappy ass flux core welder, but it's mostly filled. There are still a few little pits in here and there, but it's I think it's as strong as I'm going to get it now. Aside from, you know, a little bit more polish around here and on the other side, the handle portion is done, which means I can brass all the nails, clean them up, and then gun blue that and put the leather on. And then, I'll probably keep the leather off because I still got to brass this blade, and I don't know how the leather's going to do with the heat. But other than that, once I finish this up, then we can do the gun blue and the brassing. So, cool. So, for those of you who don't know, this is a brassing technique where you get the surface of the metal, or steel, perhaps, more so, really hot. I got map gas here. So you torch it, get it really hot, and then you take a brass brush and brush it on there. And it transfers the brass. Weak. Brass fingertips. Now I gotta do these ones, and then we'll clean them up, and then gun blue. Okay, so I have it cleaned up around the
Oh no, this is it right here. I think this is my acetone. Yeah, that's acetone. Okay, so first thing I'm going to do is put some gloves on. And I'm going to wipe down all the surfaces with acetone to get any oils off of the surface from, like, me handling it. Or when I drilled the hole through the guard. Things like that. There shouldn't be any, but last time I was experimenting with doing the Sharpie and the gun blue, I don't know, like it did something weird with the brass. That's why I cleaned off the brass around the nail. And I mean, the Sharpie worked as a resist, but it still didn't really stick to the brass that well. It did, but just like splotchily, yeah. We're going to need some tape. Do it over again. Okay, so I did two layers of Sharpie. Let's wipe down. Got some gun blue. Let's give her a shot. One, 1,000. Alright, so I'm gonna rinse it off and I'm gonna do it again. You'll see the final results when I remove the Sharpie. Alright, I did three layers per times. So much for the tape, huh? Yeah. Well, it'll clean off. So, I'm going to grab some paper towel, see if my Sharpie action worked at all. I really hope it did. Oh yeah.
The light's kind of harsh in here, but you can definitely see the contrast that's underneath as well. So, yeah, I'll do that to the rest of them, and then I'll show you guys. Alright, so here's the contrast between the brass and the gun blue. And then these guys. I think that looks so cool. One thing I did notice, though, is, yeah, see the brass around the nail here? That's where I missed getting the brass, and the gun blue, like, doesn't want to stick to it for some reason, so I'm going to have to go back in with a paintbrush, and, yeah, there's one right there, and gun blue those areas, see if I can get it to darken, but I think that looks so cool. Yep.
Alright, so I took the edge at least down to 320. I don't really know how to get this inside part clean. It's really tricky, and I will say this was, I started in February, my YouTube channel, and it took me a couple months before I actually started working with metal. But, so I've been working with metal for less than a year, so I think this is okay for less than a year of experience. You can see here, it's kind of like, blah, and it's like the line's not very good, but I hope he, Michael, understands that I am an amateur, and I've only been doing this for a year. So now I'm going to brass the blade with the brass brush, and I will tune you guys back in once the blade has been brassed, and then we'll do the leather. Well, I just brassed it. Yeah, my LED lights in here are kind of harsh, but... it's golden now. So, one thing that I want to try... Ooh, that's hot. One thing I want to try is, you know, Michael's always saying that this is such a painfully thin layer that you can't put it on a blade. So I'm going to do a little bit of testing of my own to see how easily this comes off. Because if you sandpaper it, it comes right off. So let's see how well it does against the stump. And I want to do that before I put the leather on, because chances are I'm going to have to rebrass it, and I don't want to put the torch on it when there's leather on it. So yeah, testing time. If you believe it, there's a stump right there. It is very buried. I haven't used it in a very long time, so let's see how this goes. Oh, dusty. I have a tiny shop! Bandsaw blade attached to my sock. Okay. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 20. Uh-oh. I think Michael might be full of it. The brass is still intact. It's definitely, well, I mean, it's thinner right here. The wood left more marks on the mild steel than it took the brass off. Wow, that's still hot from torching it. Wow. What's that? Nothing, just a piece of wood. That's hot. Yeah. Cool, I don't even think I have to rebrass it. I might touch it up with the Scotch-Brite, but... and then probably have to rebrass it, but... cool. Alright, so... I did end up touching up the brass. You could see gray coming through, so Michael's not completely wrong, but... it's not as fragile as he makes it out to seem. So, I'm not going to cover the handle with glue like what he does. What I do, just like what I did with the first blade that I did... I just start the leather and then wrap it around over itself, and I put a little dab of super glue on there and then continue to wrap, and then at the end I do the same thing. So yeah, let's do it. All right, mats are done. So there's the leather, golden fingernails and everything. It's a very weird dagger, but you can see I did this like X pattern on the leather, and I covered up the transition between the brass and the gun blue. I think I did a good job of hiding a lot of the evidence of me being a subpar welder.
But I think that's pretty cool looking. With the brass blade and the brass fingernails and everything. That's pretty cool. I hope Michael likes it.